Good morning. Thank you all so much for being here. It is my pleasure and deep honor to welcome everyone to our grand opening celebration and birthday party for our new westbound I-80 Yerba Buena Ramps project. Happy birthday to our new ramps. I'm Tilly Chang, director here at the County Transportation Authority. Thank you all for taking the time to join our celebration. Before I begin, I'd like to recognize several officials and special guests who are with us today. From Assemblymember David Chu's office, we have Judson Chu, Chief of Staff, over here for David. He's Chief of Staff for David, who I understand is celebrating his wedding anniversary. Had wanted to be here, but is celebrating the wedding anniversary. Smart man. And we are grateful, so grateful to Judson and Assemblymember Chu for carrying AB 2374 over the finish line this past session, which provides us and other sponsors with construction management, general contractor, delivery authority, which will help our next phase project, the West Side Ramps and Bridges, next year. From the TIDA board, we have President Fei Tsen and past chair Linda Richardson. Linda actually spoke at our groundbreaking 2.5 years ago. I'm so pleased and grateful for your participation today. And Bob Beck, our executive director from TIDA, and his team. This man gets so much done with so few words. Where's Bob? Thank you, Bob. From the TACAC, representing District 6 and herself a resident of TI, did I see Becky Hogue? I saw her last night at the tie-dye event, but Becky serves on our Citizens Advisory Committee. Thank you, Becky. And from our board, of course, we have Chair Scott Wiener and Commissioner Jane Kim's aide, Barbara Lopez, here. Thank you, Chair Wiener. And Bobby, thank you so much. We'll hear from you in a moment. And from the U.S. Coast Guard, we have Greg Riccio. Thank you, Greg, and your team, your amazing team. I met the captain as well. You've been tremendous allies throughout our project. From the CHP, we have Commander Christopher Sherry and his team, who will be speaking later as well in our program. And from the CTC, Stephen Mahler's here. Thank you so much for being here, Stephen, and for your support. And from MTC and IBADA, we have Executive Director Steve Heminger as well. Thank you, Steve. He even has his Giants cap. Next year, closer. Okay, so... no, you've got the biggest Giants fan up here as well. I'd also like to recognize several people who are unable to be here today, but who provided critical advocacy, legislative, and funding support to this project. Senators Feinstein and Boxer, State Senator Mark Leno, former State Senator Carol Migden, and Assemblymember Fiona Ma at the time. This project was a $98 million project funded by Federal Highway Bridge Program funds, not easy to get. And state Prop 1B funds, as well as local match provided by TIDA. So it was really through their efforts that we were able to help secure those funds. Governors Schwarzenegger, Brown, and Secretaries Bonner, Reinhart, Kelly, and Caltrans Directors Kempton, Iwasaki, and Dougherty, I mean, generations of leadership at the state level have all been great partners and support to our project as well. And of course, FHWA California Division Administrator Vince Mamano, who couldn't be here again, but we do have Mr. Cole, who will be speaking. And going back to the beginning of our partnership with OEWD, that's the Office of Economic and Workforce Development at the Mayor's Office in TIDA, that was in 2008. We appreciate the leadership of then Mayor Newsom and his key staff, which has continued with Mayor Lee and his administration. I don't know if Jack Sylvan is there. He is here. We worked so closely together, Jose Luis. And speaking of Jose Luis, we must recognize our great former executive director here at the TA, who again couldn't be with us. He has another opera to produce. So he sends his congratulations to all of you, all of us. Jose Luis demonstrated great commitment to this project as well, but also great wisdom in picking Eric Cordova, our amazing project manager and now deputy for capital projects, to quarterback this effort. Eric! So Eric will be up in a moment, but Eric in turn led the procurement that resulted in selection of Golden State Bridge and the A-team that is here who built the project. So Dave Riccitiello from Golden State Bridge, president, and our PB, the construction management team, PB, with Mike Scott and Bart Lytels here. Thank you so much. This group, with their team, has built this amazing project. We're really fortunate to be working with Golden State Bridge and this broader team. Not only did they manage every challenge, from the migratory birds that wouldn't migrate to the difficult and really challenging crowded site conditions. We had our project, we had the TIDA construction of the homes and the Golden Gate, the Bay Bridge project, all in the same site. So, and also they had frustratingly late shipments of critical supplies, but you guys made it all work. You pushed through like champs and you delivered this project on time and on budget. Thank you. Oops. Not only that, they met our disadvantaged business enterprise goal of 12.5%. Thank you, Dave, and for GSB's commitment to achieving that goal and to helping to create jobs and opportunities for our local small business community. Thank you for sharing those San Francisco values. Finally, we're proud of our collaboration with the local unions and workforce on this project. Later on this morning, you'll hear from Pat Karinen, who is with the Pile Drivers Local Union 34. Pat, thank you for representing labor. And how important, this is such an important project. You'll be speaking about that to their local workforce. Because of your collective efforts, as policymakers, community leaders, funders, and project delivery partners and builders, we are here to celebrate the opening of the YBI Westbound Ramps project. This is a connection to the future of Yerba Buena and Treasure Islands. How about a round of applause for all of you? Now, for our Transportation Authority staff, many of whom I'm so glad are here, this was a really special initiative because it was our first large-scale construction project that we led and delivered from A to Z. I'd like to take a moment to recognize several key team members from the SFCTA who have been critical to the success of this project. Of course, first and foremost, Eric Cordova, Deputy for Capital Projects, our project manager and a human project delivery juggernaut. Anna LaForte, Deputy Director for Policy and Programming, and her staff who helped us get all those funds and keep our part funding partners coordinated. Maria Lombardo, our Chief Deputy Director. Cynthia Fong, Deputy Director for Finance and Administration, whose team just booked the 7th straight year of clean federal audits. Go Cal and your team. And Eric Young, our Communications Officer, and Bridget Smith, our fabulous graphics designer, who's done a fabulous job presenting our project to the public. Thank you all. Please join me in giving this team a hand for their excellent teamwork. Now, speaking of excellence in transportation, it is my pleasure to introduce our chair, Scott Wiener, who has led the TA for the past 2 years and who also represents San Francisco on the Metropolitan Transportation Commission. Chair Wiener.
Thank you, Tilly. And I want to just thank Tilly Chang and her incredible staff, as well as Jose Luis Moscovich. We are really blessed in San Francisco to have amazing, amazing transportation leaders at our Transportation Authority, as well as at our MTA and in our planning department. And we are really lucky in terms of just the internal capacity that we have to do good work in San Francisco and to work with our regional partners to make sure that we're all moving forward together. So thank you, Tilly. This is really exciting. And on the one hand, when you first look at what this event is about, it's about an off-ramp. And you might be tempted to say, oh, it's just an off-ramp. Well, it's not just an off-ramp. This is really one of the, I think, early steps towards the complete and utter transformation of Treasure Island and Yerba Buena Island to be an amazing, sustainable, urban, walkable community to help with all of our really daunting goals here in San Francisco and the Bay Area around housing in particular and transportation as well. And of course, when this project is done, and it will be done, and it's going to be phenomenal, it's going to house 20,000 people with a great commitment to affordable housing and also to formerly homeless residents. We're going to see wonderful transportation improvements relating to the bridge, but also robust ferry service. We need to make better use of our ferries here in the Bay Area. And it's just going to be amazing. And the fact that this effort, for both for these off-ramps, but ultimately for the entire project, will be such a great regional collaboration is a real testament to where we need to go. Because we know that today in the Bay Area, we can no longer go it alone as San Francisco or any other community. We're all in this together around housing and transportation in particular. This project will ultimately, I think, show that in spades. And so I want to just thank all of the agencies that made this possible, including our federal government and the state, the MTC, on which I serve, as well as our local and county agencies, and the Coast Guard as well. This is one of those it takes a family kind of situations, and I'm just really honored to be here and to be able to take this great step forward. So thank you.
Thank you so much, Chair Weiner. And next, let me welcome Barbara Lopez, legislative aide to District 6 Supervisor Jane Kim. Chair Kim also serves as our Treasure Island Mobility Management Agency chair. So, Barbara?
Good afternoon, everybody. It's a pleasure to be here with all of you. I think the last 2 days have been a really great day for the Treasure Island and Yerba Buena communities. How many folks were out last night celebrating tie-dye? Yes. Let's hear. Give it a hand for tie-dye. Tie-dye is an amazing organization that serves as an anchor here in Treasure Island, helping homeless families and definitely stabilizing the community and helping build what we're going to look forward to. And it makes sense that we talk about tie-dye when we talk about the opening of the ramp, because these are the kind of partners we have and need to create a smart, sustainable city. I know our office has worked with all of you for many, many years. And even before our office, many of you were working on these items for 10 plus years to make sure that we have the kind of design, whether it's bike access or car access or ferry access or the kind of transportation access that we need to make this a sustainable community. We talk about that a lot, what a sustainable community looks like. But I think that the joint commitment of folks like Caltrans and the County Authority Board, TIDA, TIMA, the residents of Treasure Island, all the other partners who are here, the mayor's office, with our office shows that, A, we're able to get affordable housing at the levels that we need to create the communities we want, and B, we can create the infrastructure on time projects to make sure that our residents have the kind of transport that they need to get to work or to enjoy the city. So I just want to, again, thank everybody here and just say that really this was your work. I think line staff don't always get the level of respect and support that we need to show. You come and you brief our offices and we nod our heads and we agree or we disagree, but really you're the ones who are doing the plans, the engineering plans, the plans to make sure that the projects go forward on time. So thank you.
Thank you, Bobby. Thank you so much. Next, we're honored to have Faye Tan, president of the TIDA board. Faye, we're so fortunate to have the trust and partnership of TIDA, which is doing an amazing job overseeing implementation of the overall development mission and vision for TI. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Welcome, everybody, to Treasure Island and Yerba Buena Island. What a beautiful day for this opening. My name is Faye Sen. I serve as the president of the board of directors of the Treasure Island Development Authority. But before I begin, I'd like to recognize my fellow board members, especially the past chair, Linda Richardson. Raise your hand, Linda Richardson. And Mark Dunlop is here as well. Mark is on the authority. We also have John Paul Samaha, Larry Mazzola, and Sam Moss, who are not here, but they are members of the board we work very diligently for Treasure Island affairs. I'd also like to recognize, actually, one of the most important people at Treasure Island, and it is Bob Beck, who is the executive director of the Treasure Island Development Authority. All of you know Bob, and you know his staff. And it is because of Bob and his staff that we are here today. So thank you so much, Bob. You know, we have a vision for Treasure Island. It is a vision which has taken 3 decades to make, and it has gone through years of community consensus, environmental review, and it is incredible that we are finally at this point where we are starting the infrastructure and we are doing the work, starting the construction for making Treasure Island the reality that we've all dreamed about. We very much appreciate the work of all of you in doing this. These ramps, the old ramp, was so antiquated. And in order to build the vision that we have of 8,000 homes, of 300 acres of parklands and open space with pedestrian pathways and bicycle pathways that we have envisioned, we need to have the access. And these ramps are the way to give us the access. It expands the east side. We are working on the west side as well with the Transportation Authority. Oops, well, there goes that. But we want to applaud the Transportation Authority's dedication to this project. They have been great partners from the planning stages to the funding plan, to the financing role they played, to the smooth and timely project delivery of the grants. It's been a great job. And thanks to you all at the federal, state, and regional levels who have supported us in this effort. And a shout out to Golden State Bridge contractors who have been an excellent team working with us to this successful conclusion. This is not the end of the Transportation Authority's work on YPI and Treasure Island. We look forward to working with them on many additional important projects. We have the website ramps ahead. We're working together to realize our overall development plan, and we're working for a comprehensive transportation policy, which will also provide accessibility, not just through cars, but through the ferries, through transit, public transit, because that's a very important part of the overall plan of accessibility for Treasure Island. So thank you again to the Transportation Authority, to Caltrans, and to TIDA staff, and to all the partners who have worked so hard to make today happen. Thank you, Advance, for your continued support.
Thank you so much, Faye. This really is the first of many connections to the future that we're partnering on. Next, we welcome our great friend and leader at Caltrans District 4, Chief Deputy District Director Dan McElhaney. Dan's team worked closely with us every step of the way to ensure a successful connection to the east span of the Bay Bridge. Thank you, Dan.
Wow, it's a great day here in San Francisco at Treasure Island. Thank you for having us, Caltrans, as part of the team. Of course, for our great bridge here in the Bay Bridge area, to have these ramps not only provide safety on Main Line for traffic moving through the YBI tunnel westbound, but also for access to the island. That left-hand ramp to the island will be closed by Saturday night. Yay! Again, I'm Dan McLam, your Chief Deputy District Director for Caltrans in the Bay Area. And when the city and the region and the state and the federal can come together for the Bay Area and show how competitive we can be statewide for those highway bridge funds, it's a very competitive process. It's really about building trust and confidence in what we deliver to date. And we're competing for some more highway bridge funds for the next ramp going eastbound. So I want to thank Tilly and obviously Eric and the board members for the TA, excellent leadership for us, for TIDA, excellent leadership from the board. CTC is here, Mr. Maller, MTC, Steve Heminger, great leader for us on the Bay Bridge, chaired the Bay Bridge Oversight Committee for many years during its construction and completion. And as we compete for those limited bridge seismic retrofit account funds and come together, our Caltrans staff, there aren't many, in support of this job. They're a very small group, but they do a lot of great work in support of Tilly and Bob Beck and I to make things happen in our local assistance, local projects group, in bridge design, construction advisors, project coordination. They're very proud to serve side-by-side with the TA and TIDA staff, Caltrans maintenance. Many of them here now, maybe they just raised their hand. I want to thank them all for doing a great job, Caltrans staff, in helping make everybody successful. Of course, over my 30 years, I've worked with a lot of contractors, and Golden State Bridge has turned out to be really one of the best, and we're very impressed. So thank you for your quality, your schedule, your cost effectiveness, solving problems, because Eric and I are tackling a number of projects behind the scenes, and it's about problem solving coming together as a team. So thank you for your delivery, Golden State Bridge. The benefits of these ramps, it's now about location. We've overcome the geometrics. Drivers will have visibility that they never had on the previous ramp, so the safety has changed a lot since the 1930s. Emergency vehicles, driver safety, and a long service. These bridges are going to be in service for a long, long time, so the investment will last many, many years for the communities on YBI and Treasure Island. Lastly, I want to thank the U.S. Coast Guard again and the California Highway Patrol, and maybe I'll wrap up with, if we could just give a round of applause for all our women and men that serve in uniform statewide as well as nationwide. Thank you very much.
Speaking of which, now we thank you, Dan. And now we're honored to have Commander of the California Highway Patrol, San Francisco office, Captain Christopher Sherry. Thank you, Commander, for keeping our crews safe and supporting our launch this weekend and beyond.
Congratulations to the SFCTA, TIDA, Caltrans, and all of their partners on this project. The interchange looks fabulous. Unsafe roadways and insufficient traffic flows can lead to collisions and injuries. The Yerba Buena I-80 interchange improvement project will provide safe and efficient access to Yerba Buena Island and Treasure Island from the San Francisco-Oakland Bay Bridge. This will improve traffic safety and traffic efficiency on the on-ramps for all of us. The mission of the California Highway Patrol is to provide the highest level of safety, service, and security. And you can count that the California Highway Patrol will be there to enforce our laws on this interchange and be there to assist any disabled motorists. We're proud to participate in this momentous achievement, which will support San Francisco's newest and emerging neighborhood. We're very proud to be here to work on one of the most beautiful bridges in the world, which leads to the most beautiful city in the world. Thank you.
Hear, hear. Thank you so much, Commander Sherry. And now, before I turn the show over to the man of the hour and the biggest lover of San Francisco, Eric Cordova, let me say a few words about Eric. Eric is someone who I learn from every day, and who he is leading a dynamic and transformative team here at the TA, leading us into a whole new role of a project delivery agency with expertise, deep expertise, experience, and integrity. Having worked with six TAs, we were lucky to get him. Sure, Jose Luis had charmed him, and together they'd laid a great foundation with early stages of the project going pretty smoothly. But Eric could have delivered the project as our consultant and not joined the TA. What I think made the difference in his joining our agency was that Eric cared so much about this project and so much about San Francisco, having been born and raised here in the city in the Excelsior. He wanted to contribute on another level in public service, to work with the community, and to mentor the next generation of staff. So, Eric, congratulations to you and to your family who are all here today. Thank you for your hard work, your dedication, and your sacrifice to get this job done. You know, the Giants may have come up short this year, but you, sir, hit it out of the park. And I know you're just getting started.
Hi, everybody. Thank you very much, Tilly. You know, on behalf of the Transportation Authority's Capital Projects Division, I want to thank everyone for coming today. This has definitely been a labor of love for me. Yes, I am a native San Francisco and very proud of it. San Francisco is the best city in the world. This is truly an exciting day for the Transportation Authority to celebrate, you know, the completions of the YBI on and off ramps, the westbound on and off ramps, and it's on time and on budget, and we're all very proud of that. But I couldn't have done it, you know, we couldn't have done it without everybody here as part of it. And I'm going to thank a lot of people. I want to give a little history lesson, though, very quickly, because I have been working on the project since 2008, and that's when we started the environmental documentation process. You know, we went ahead and got the approved environmental EIS, EIR, within 3 years by the December of 2011 timeframe. We completed the design and the right-of-way certification efforts 2 years later, and basically awarded a contract to Golden State Bridge. And Dave Riccitiello, thank you so much for your continued and hard-working pursuit of this project and problem-solving, as Dan indicated. It's a credit to your company and the way that you do business. Thank you very much in that regard. We started work and actually really started work in February 2014. So it's about 2.5 years, a little bit over 2.5 years, and we're now ready to open the ramps. So I think we've done a good job in that regard in terms of meeting schedule in the overall schedule that we had in front of us. And I want to make sure that everybody understands that when you manage projects like this, it really, in my opinion, is really the players that are involved. It's a sense of ownership. It's a sense of, hey, we've got to get the job done. And there's nobody in this room who's done that more than Mike Scott from WSP Parsons Brinckerhoff. Mike has been living and breathing this job since day one, actively managing the contract, actively looking ahead to see where there are things that need to be done, and frankly, managing change. All of these projects have change. And the issue, and the success factor is really how you manage that change. Congratulations to Mike, too, because he's going to help the Bay Area Toll Authority on one of their contracts there on the Richmond Bridge. So you got a winner there, Steve. I appreciate your tireless efforts, Mike. You know, about a year ago or so, you know, Scott, and you came to visit the job, and we showed you how it looked. One of the things you had said, and actually Commissioner Kim also said, was, you know, we haven't heard any complaints. We really haven't heard anything. And our whole mode of operation has been, hey, let's just get it done. So when we hear things like that, that's music to our ears. That means that we're doing our job the way it's supposed to be done. I'm going to get into some geeky engineering facts, but I think they're important to note because this is a massive project in that regard. It's really five bridge structures interconnected that form the on and off ramp system. We built major retaining wall systems, temporary roads to ensure access to and from the Coast Guard property there and Homeland Security interests. We actually relocated a naval base, Quarters 10, in Buildings 267, as they're called. We relocated them right across the cove there. That building right there is now going to be in future use by the Treasure Island Development Authority. It's actually a mini park sitting. It's really a really cool feature of the project. 12,500 cubic yards of structural concrete, and we'll hear later this morning from Julie Berry, who's the company that basically provided and pumped all that concrete. 1,400 truckloads of off-haul soil transport, and we, you know, I think one thing that's really important to note here too is that we met our disadvantaged business enterprise goals. That is a task that doesn't always happen on projects, and we're very proud of that fact. And I want to thank, in particular, Golden State Bridge for their commitment to meeting that disadvantaged business enterprise goal, and also to Paul Pendergast and Pendergast Consulting for working with the DBE contracting community to get the word out and make sure that you went ahead and helped us meet that goal and make sure that the DBE community knew about all the different trades and work to be done. I appreciate your efforts, Paul, in that regard. 5 million pounds of reinforcing steel, 37,000 feet of steel piling driven into the ground. That's 7 miles of piling for all the foundation systems. 185 tons of structural steel. Happy to report that we are compliant with the federal Buy America provisions. This is a federally funded project, and we received clean audits on all front. Very proud of that fact. I can't say enough about the team. And I'm going to very quickly mention other players that were involved here. Dave, and in particular, Paul Lukowitz, who was Dave's project manager. He's not here today. He's up in Reading building another bridge. please say thank you to Paul for me and Ryan Hagen, who hopefully is here with us today. He's still managing the project. He's out there doing his work. We mentioned Mike Scott, Bart Lytell, Jake Jones, Matt Bolander, and Mike Berger. Thank you all for your efforts. They're part of the construction management inspection team. AECOM and Moffitt Nickel are the engineers' design of record. I see Corey Lang. I'm glad you made it. I see Sam Chewy. Sam Chewy is a gentleman who has worked on this project since the very beginning. And his commitment, I appreciate your commitment, Sam. Thank you very much. Ho-Sheng Lee, Al Eli, they are structural engineers, some of the top-notch structural engineers in the country working with us on this part of the team. Also from Caltrans. You know, every Wednesday morning we have meetings to talk about construction. What are we doing? What's going on? The schedules that are brought forth. How do we coordinate it? Miran from Caltrans, Bill Howe, Deanna Vilcek, and Steve Whipple, thank you all for your efforts in that regard, in particular Miran. Thank you so much. And Asan there too. Thank you. FHWA, Greg Coley, and Peter Pangalan, thank you for your support and working with us in all of the funding and just oversight from a structural standpoint. Can't say enough about Greg Rescio, who I call the mayor of YBI, just because Greg has been great to work with. He's basically making sure we all don't forget that, hey, the Coast Guard is here, and this is our home also. So thank you very much. And then Bob Beck from TIDA, Rich Rivetti, Liz Hirshhorn, and Wei Zhang. Thanks to all the staff. I'm not sure a lot of people know, but I was a consultant for about 30 years and had my own company for 15, and I was registered as a disadvantaged business enterprise. And I know how important it is to go ahead and reach out to the community to meet those goals. I'm actually honored to work at the Transportation Authority because they understand the value and the merit as it relates to getting small, local, and disadvantaged business enterprise firms on the project. The federal DBE program is meant to put men, women, minorities, and disadvantaged firms to work, create jobs, build community, and build their companies. And I'm happy to say that we've done that as part of this project. That means a lot to me personally. When the Transportation Authority team with Caltrans and FHWA on other projects, and in particular Doyle Drive, we came across a remarkable woman by the name of Julie Berry, who's the owner of Calcon Pumping. Nice piece of equipment, Julie, right there to our right. Julie and her team pumped millions of pounds of concrete on that project. And lo and behold, her home base is Treasure Island. This is where she operates out of. So when the YBI project came along, we were thrilled to see that Golden State Bridge had chosen Calcon Pumping to go ahead and provide the concrete here for the project and help us meet our goals. So I just want to, right now, actually, ladies and gentlemen, just join me in welcoming Julie Berry to the podium.
Thank you, Eric, for that gracious introduction. It does make me especially proud to not only work on the YBI Ramps project, but to be located right here on Treasure Island. Our pumps are actually located on Avenue M, and our administration building is in the building where we had the refreshments. We're up on the fourth floor, 91 steps to the top, by the way. No gym membership required. We just go up and down the stairs four times a day. As many of you know, it's quite expensive for small businesses to be located on San Francisco, and even more so when you have a fleet of concrete pumping trucks. This truck that you see over here on the right was one of the pumps that was used for the project. It's called a 39-meter Schwing pump. It has a vertical reach of about 135 feet. It can pump 180 cubic yards per hour. And if you think about it, one ready-mix truck can carry 9 cubic yards. So you're pumping out the concrete pretty fast. For us, as our business has developed and having the incredible honor to work on such projects as the Doyle Drive replacement project, the Transbay Transit Center, the Bay Bridge, the High Street Bridge in Oakland, and several BART projects, and many more, one of the challenges we have faced is finding a space that is not only large enough for our fleet of pumps, but affordable. I want to take this opportunity to thank Bob Bett and Rich Rivetti. I don't think Rich Rivetti is in the office, area here today, but from TIDA for their amazing assistance in making Treasure Island our home. Many times our crews arrive before sunrise and after sunset, but when our wheels hit Yerba Buena Island, we know we're home and we're safe off the road. For those of you who have never experienced standing in front of One Avenue of the Palms, which is where we just were with the refreshments, at 6:30 a.m. in the morning, with the harvest moon setting over the Golden Gate Bridge, the city skyline shimmering to the left, and the sun is just about to come up behind you, you simply have to put that on your bucket list. Dan McElhaney, I want to thank you, Caltrans and FHWA, for providing so many opportunities for Calcom pumping on your projects. It is greatly appreciated. As Eric mentioned, we are fortunate to have been selected by Golden State Bridge to be on their winning team for this project. From the very start, this has been a dream job. The Golden State Bridge team, working with Mike Scott and his team at PB, and of course, working for the SFCTA, has been literally fantastic. From a construction management perspective, their schedules were solid, their on-site management was impeccable, and their attention to safety and compliance was absolutely remarkable. And to Dave with GSB, that starts at the top, man. And we really appreciate your support. To the SFCTA, I want to share with you one of the challenges that many of small and disadvantaged firms face. It's the long lead time between performing the work, invoicing for the work, and then waiting to be paid. We've had the honor to work with a large number of projects with public works agencies. And I can say without a doubt that we were paid the fastest on this project than any other project we've worked on. And that's a tribute to Dave and his team for turning around the funds to small business. Working with the SFCTA's DB team was exceptional. When we had an issue, it was addressed, and we were always made to feel that our contributions really mattered, that we were really a part of something important. And to the design team who envisioned these gorgeous, elegant new ramps, as someone who runs a fleet of very long rigs, we love you. And I'm sure the citizens love it too. Now we have an option of what an on and off ramp we use when getting on and off the island. If any of you have ever been caught on the Bay Bridge because a rig has gotten caught up in the off ramps, you know exactly what I mean. These new ramps are going to really make an impact on the daily lives of people living and doing business on Treasure Island. So to the SFCTA and Golden State Bridge, thank you for the opportunity. To TIDA, thank you for allowing us to call Treasure Island our home at one of the most exciting times in this history of the island. And to all of you, thank you for supporting small, local firms that are hiring from our communities and building the types of projects we can all be extremely proud of. And then also a shout out to Paul Pendergast. Seriously, you are one of the best people that is just an advocate for small business and helps us, and we really appreciate it. Thank you.
There. I was just too busy thanking Julie for being an amazing business leader, not just of the DB community, but of just business in general. We need more stellar leaders like you, Julie. Thank you. And next we have Mr. Pat Karinen from Pile Drivers Local Union 34, representing the folks who got this job done, representing all the unions. We had Local 261, the laborers, Leona, we had the operating engineers, we had the carpenters. Pat's going to talk about that. Thank you so much, Pat.
Good afternoon. I want to thank David from Golden State Bridge and the authority for allowing me to speak. I heard a lot of talk, 8 years in planning and 2.5 years to get the work done. So it's, you know, all the trades are involved in this project. And, you know, David told me it had 200,000 work hours out here and one twisted ankle, which is a testament to his company for safety and keeping folks out of trouble. And as somebody that's had to help folks put their lives back together when somebody's been hurt or killed on a job, I really appreciate that. And, you know, the overall project, I've been dealing with the Bay Bridge since it first started, and I'm glad to see it's finishing up now, and I'm really happy and happy for our trades. And the whole job, you think about it, there hasn't been one real serious accident out there, and no fatalities, and we really appreciate that, us guys in the trades, and thank you all.
So with that, I just want to thank all of our speakers and all of you again for your attendance today, your support, for this celebration that you'll help us continue as we move forward into the lunch program. But first, let me thank again the folks who organize this. We have our Chief Communications Officer, Eric Young, his staff, including Bridget Smith, Paul Pendergast, who put on this amazing event. There you go. I mean, he's just a business leader, advocate, all that. Paul, thank you so much for delivering a tremendous event. And we also have beautiful food from caterer Jay Jardine, who provided the morning refreshments as well as our lunchtime food as well. May also please enjoy the food, and then we'll have shuttles to take you all up to see the project and enjoy the view up there and just see the tremendous result of everybody's hard work. For now, if I could invite those speakers and the folks in the front to join me on the side, we're going to head up there quickly to do a quick ribbon cutting. Thank you. Thank you, everyone.